Hi there, thank you so much for joining me today. This video is going to be a monthly makeup basket for the month of May. I thought I would do a different setup today. I'm actually just sitting down. I have the products that I had in my last makeup basket for April, and I have the products in my new basket, and I'm going to tell you what I'm replacing what with. And that way I can kind of give you some small reviews on the products, whether or not I liked them, if I'm keeping everything, stuff like that, just to be a little bit more in depth with it. I thought this would help kind of mesh last month's makeup basket with this month and kind of give you a better idea of what I'm working with. So let me know if you like this setup. Let me know if you prefer the way I've been doing it for the past 2 months, where I've kind of just been going through each drawer and picking products out. I'm just gonna get started. So let's start with makeup setting sprays. So I'm going to keep the Urban Decay All Nighter setting spray this month, and I'm going to replace the Pure Miracle Mist with the Ofra makeup setting spray. It's in a Mario Badescu facial spray bottle, just because I prefer the nozzle on this one. The nozzle on the Ofra one is garbage. They're both 8 ounces, so it fits perfectly. And I'm gonna give it a shot this month and see if I like it. From what I've read and from what I've seen, it seems like this doesn't have a high alcohol content like the Urban Decay one does. So maybe I'll use this more for like an everyday setting spray, just to get the powdery look down, and use the Urban Decay one when I really feel like I need my makeup to last a long time. Alright, so now let's look at eyeshadow palettes. Last month I had the Urban Decay Shade and Light eyeshadow palette pulled out, and I will keep this month because it's in my project pan and I'm just trying to get some better use out of it. This is what it looks like. I don't know if you're going to be able to see, but I have pan in this top shade, and I also have it in this white shade here. Just going to get some more use out of it. And then I also had a Z palette of a bunch of different singles. I have a mesh of ColourPop, Makeup Geek, Tarte, Urban Decay, all different kinds of singles in here. I've really been loving playing with them, but I think I'm going to put them away this month and focus on an old favorite, which is the Modern Renaissance palette by Anastasia Beverly Hills. I haven't touched this palette since Christmas time, and I'd like to pull it out and use it some more. I really enjoy it, and I'm kind of itching to start using this Realgar shade again. It's a beautiful orange. Really excited to pull this out and use it a little bit more. I do have 3 non-makeup products that I'm pulling out this month. They are 3 facial sprays from Pacifica. This one is the Rose Flower Hydra Mist. This one is the Crystal Power Hydra Mist. And this one is the Coconut Essence Hydra Mist. And they were all $10, and I got them on Ulta's website for $5 for half off. And you guys know how much I love facial mists, so I thought I would pull these out and review them. I think I have like 8 or 9 different face sprays at this point, all from different brands. And so I think I'm going to do some more research, review them for a little bit longer, and do a best and worst facial spray video. Let me know if you'd be interested in seeing that. It won't be on toners, it won't be on makeup setting sprays, they'll just be for facial mists. So let me know if you'd be interested in seeing a video like that. So I'm going to be playing around with these this month. I'm really excited. Also, I have some leftover henna on my hand. A good friend of mine, Krupa, asked if she could practice her henna skills on my hand, and it's beautiful, but it's starting to fade, so if you see anything on my hand, that's what it is. Now for bronzers and contour products. Last month I had NARS Laguna, and I had the Kevin Aucoin Sculpting Powder in the shade Light. The bronzer was actually in my project pan, and I've actually already hit pan on it, which is way, way sooner than I thought it would. So I thought, since I've already hit goal on the 2 bronzers in my project pan, I am going to play around with some other bronzers in my collection that I feel like I'm neglecting a little bit. The first bronzer I pulled out is the Charlotte Tilbury Filmstar Bronze and Glow. It just has the most beautiful and luxurious packaging. It's basically brand new. I think I've only used this once or twice. So I am going to be using this as a bronzer and as a sculpting product, and then of course I'll also be using the highlight as well. And the other bronzer I pulled out is the Pure Cosmetics Glow Together palette. This was a limited edition product, and I feel like I never use it, so I'm going to pull this out and play with it a little bit more. I forgot to mention I brought out 2 single shadows to play around with this month. The first one is by Wet n Wild. It's in the shade Brulee. And this is just a cream colored powder, pretty standard. I'll probably try and get some more use out of this, either cleaning up the outside of my eyeshadow or using it to set under my brow bone or just set my eyeshadow primer, just to get some more use out of it. I feel like it sits around and I never reach for it because it's a single, so I'm going to try to use it a little bit more this month. And the other single shadow is a Glazen Eye Gloss from Butter London, and it's in the shade Oil Slick. I got this for half off during the Ulta 21 Days of Beauty sale, and I was so, so excited. I have been wanting to try this for the longest time, so let me give you a close-up. It's got like a jelly texture, but it still goes back to its original place. And it's just a really nice color, kind of like a duochrome. So it's got a purpley brownish base, and then it has a green blue shift to it, and also has pink in there. I don't know if you're going to be able to see that as well. Maybe let the light hit it. Yeah, I don't know if you can see the pink, but it's a gorgeous shade, and I definitely want to play around with this a little bit this month. I'm excited to see what kind of looks I can come up with it. I've never used anything like it before, so I think it's definitely going to have a learning curve, but I think I'll be able to figure it out. For blushes, last month I pulled out the Tarte Mini Blush in the shade Party. That's what it looks like up close. It was like a nice nude brown. Really nice. I definitely liked using it. I also pulled out the Afterglow Blush by Urban Decay in the shade Bittersweet. Beautiful packaging, and it's a beautiful color. I actually ended up using this quite a few times. I'll try to link below some videos that I wore this with. It's definitely not as bright purple as it looks in the pan. It definitely shears out a little bit once you apply it. Beautiful shade, I really enjoyed wearing it. And the third blush I had was the Essence Blush Up Powder Blush in the shade Heatwave. It was kind of like an ombre, two-toned type of blush. One side was more pink and one side was more orange. Really beautiful, definitely not as scary pigmented as I thought it was going to be. So this top shade is Bittersweet by Urban Decay. This middle one is the Essence Blush. And this bottom one is Tarte's Party. So the first blush I'm pulling out is the Jordana Baked Eyeshadow in the shade Orange Shock. This is a dupe for the NARS Taj Mahal blush. I talked about it in my most recent dupes video. Really beautiful orange shade with a gold shimmer. This is what it looks like on the top here. It definitely is a lot more orange than it looks like on camera. And really excited to play with this a little bit more. I think this color would be really great for the summertime. The second blush is the Afterglow Blush by Urban Decay in the shade Fetish. Once again, I just never reach for my Urban Decay blushes, so I'm pulling them out. I'm making a point to use them. Once again, packaging's beautiful, and it's more of like a nudie pink blush. That's what I have on the bottom there. Slightly more mauve-y and purple. Definitely think I'll get some more use out of this month. And then the third one is a bronzer by Urban Decay, and it's the Sun-Kissed shade from their Beached Bronzer collection. This is way, way too warm to be an actual bronzer for me, so I end up using it as a bronzy blush. It's actually what I'm wearing today, and I think it kind of gives me more of like a bronzy glow. I just really love the packaging for this, and it's something that I never really think to use, so I'm pulling it out to use it more specifically this month. So once again, this top shade is the Orange Shock Shadow from Jordana. This is the Beached Bronzer from Urban Decay in the shade Sunkissed, and this is Fetish by Urban Decay. For mascara, I used up the Jordana Volumizing Best Lash Extreme Mascara. I talked about that in my most recent empties. I've decided to bring out my old favorite, the Essence Lash Princess Mascara. Really, really like this mascara. That's what the brush looks like. Really nothing special. I do think it's mostly the formula that I really enjoy. It is very, very gloopy or slightly clumpy when you first get it, and so the first three or four times I use it, I kind of wipe off the excess off on a tissue, and it works beautifully, and I really enjoy it. It's really great at building up too. If you want like extra length and volume, you can wait for it to dry and add a second layer. Really excited to have this back out this month. I'm kind of all over the place. I'm not really going in any particular order if you can't notice, but the next product I'm going to talk about is primers. So last month I pulled out the Becca First Light Priming Filter. This was nice. I didn't see anything crazy different between wearing it and not wearing it. I think I need to give it a little bit more use to figure out if I like it, but I don't think it's going to be the most appropriate for me in the summertime because I need something to kind of keep the oils at bay. I don't think this is going to do that, so I'm going to put it away this month. This was very new to me last month, and I am glad that I got to pull it out and try it for a bit, but once again, it's too moisturizing of a primer to really help me hone in the oils and keep my makeup lasting longer now that the weather's gotten a lot warmer, so I am going to put this away. And I'm pulling out the Tarte's Poreless Primer. I feel like I never use this. I always say I'm going to use it once the warmer months come, and then I never do. So I'm pulling it out. It's the Clean Slate Poreless 12-Hour Perfecting Primer. This is a very silicone-y, thicker primer. I'm going to really give it some use this month and see if it's something I think is worth keeping, or if it's something that I feel like really doesn't do anything. I'm going to really test it out and see if it's worth it this month. I also bought a new primer. This was once again from the Ulta 21 Days of Beauty. It was half off. I couldn't resist. I always hear such good things about it. It's the Urban Decay Eyeshadow Priming Potion in the anti-aging version. And that's what it looks like on the outside. Really cute packaging. And I think the newer ones have a doe foot applicator. And I don't think the old ones used to have that. So that's a really nice touch. This was only $10. There's a crap ton of product in here. So I'm really excited to test this out this month. As for my under eye setting powder, I'm going to keep using the Besame Purple Powder. It's the translucent powder in Brightening Violet. And I really enjoy this. I love using it to set my under eyes, so I'm going to continue using it. And I use it with a makeup wedge. That's how I apply it. I have another new addition to my makeup collection, which is the Milani Keep It Smooth Luxe Lip Treatment. And really cute packaging. I think this was like $10. It's a little bit more expensive than some other affordable lip balms that I've seen. This is what it looks like on the inside. Definitely a little bit thinner than I guess I would like it to be. I've only used it once or twice, but it smells phenomenal. My lips have been a little bit better than normal, but they're still pretty dry, so I'm trying to get some more lip balms back into my collection. I used up 3 last month, which is crazy, so I need to restock and get some more. If you have any recommendations for like a really good, thick, affordable lip balm, let me know, please. As for perfumes, I was actually able to use up quite a few perfume samples last month, and I really liked how my progress went, so I thought I'd do it again. So I pulled out 5 perfumes. These are all from the brand Commodity. They are in the fragrances Rain, Mimosa, Gold, Magnolia, and Tea. I feel like I can finish these up by the end of the month. Now for highlighters. I pulled out 3 highlighters last month, and I brought in 3 new highlighters to replace them this month. The first one was the Wet n Wild Reserve Your Cabana Bronzer. Not really a bronzer, definitely a more of a subtle highlight. Really great for every day for the office. I definitely think I've made the pan a lot bigger this month. Enjoyed using it. I'm going to put it away for now. Same with the Flexitarian highlighter. This is from ColourPop. Super, super bright and shimmery, and also really nice to wear on your collarbones if you want a little bit of a pop. I do like the formula of this, and I am going to be putting another liquid highlighter in for this month. This is the Cover FX Cover Enhancing Drops in the shade Moonlight. Beautiful shade. Definitely want to play around with this. I feel like I've had this sample for a long time and I've never actually used it, so I'm going to pull it out and use it this month. I also had last month the Ofra highlighter in the shade Pillow Talk. Gorgeous, gorgeous pinky highlight. If you're someone who's fair like me, I think this would look so, so nice on you. Really enjoy this formula. It was my first Ofra highlighter, but I'll definitely be getting some more in the future because it was really nice. And the other 2 highlighters that I'm pulling in this month, the first one is the Laura Geller highlighter in the shade Peach Glow. It's one of their baked highlighters, and I really enjoy using this. It might be like the teeniest, tiniest bit too dark for my skin, but I feel like I can make it work. If I really bronze everything up, I feel like I can make it work. And out of the 3 highlighters I have this month, this is definitely my more subtle one, so this is probably going to be my everyday highlighter. And the other highlighter is from The Balm. It is the Mary Luminizer. This is one of my oldest highlighters. I've even hit pan on it, and I feel like I never, ever use it. So I'm definitely going to pull it out. Definitely a blinding champagne-y gold highlight. On my index finger is Mary Luminizer. On my middle finger is Peach Glow. You can definitely tell this one's way, way more pigmented. Definitely have slightly different undertones. This one is going to be like my party highlighter. This is going to be when I'm trying to punch it up. As for foundation, I'm keeping the Smashbox 15-Hour Wear Hydrating Foundation. I've been applying this with my fingers and really liking the outcome, so I'm going to hold on to it. It's definitely nicer when I want less coverage for the day. And then when I want full coverage, I actually recently purchased the Jouer Full Coverage Foundation. This is in the shade Buff, and it's actually a light shade with an olive undertone, and it's high coverage. Definitely something I want to play around with some more this month so I can get an actual thought on it, because I've been trying to make it work. I've been mixing it with the NYX foundation mixture in the shade White, and this is also a new purchase from last month, and it's just a white foundation mixer, and mixing them together I get a good shade match, and I think I might have an olive undertone, you guys. I'm still trying to test it out and see if it's true, but I really feel like this is the right undertone for me. Finally, after all these years, I feel like I finally found it, so excited to play with those 2 foundations this month. Those are really the only 2 liquid foundations that I own besides a Physicians Formula BB Cream. These next 2 products are ones you've probably seen all the time. It's the By Terry Hyaluronic Hydra Powder. This isn't my project pan. The Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Pomade in the shade Taupe is also my project pan. I'm going to hold on to these and try to get some more use out of them, but I'm also going to pull in 2 other eyebrow products. The first one is the ColourPop Brow Pencil in the shade Dope Taupe. This is more of like a warmer shade. It's not taupe at all. And the other one is new to my collection. It's the LA Girl Shady Slim Brow Pencil in the shade Auburn. I figured since I'm playing around with like strawberry blondes and more reds in my hair, and I think I'll be going a little bit redder just for a little bit soon, I wanted to get an Auburn redhead type of brow pencil, so I'll definitely be playing with those this month too, since I want to warm up my brows to match my hair. As for concealers, I have the LA Girl Pro Conceal and I have the Tarte Shape Tape. I'm holding on to both of these. They're both almost done. I've even pulled the stopper out of the Tarte concealer, so this one has to be almost finished. And yeah, I'm just gonna try to finish these up this month. I do have another color corrector, once again new to my collection. I bought it last month. It's the NYX Dark Circle Concealer. It's in a little pot form. It's got more of a, like a salmon pinky undertone. I think this would work nicely for color correcting underneath my eyes. I've only used it once or twice, so I don't have any real opinions, but I definitely want to get some more use out of this month, especially since my other color correcting product is going to be almost finished. I also pulled out the Ulta lip primer. It's an exact dupe for the MAC lip primer. And I feel like I've just been forgetting about this. It's like an extra step that I forget to use. And I really enjoyed using up the MAC one, so I'm going to try and get some more use out of the Ulta one this month. I'm also keeping the NYX Epic Ink Liner, and I'm also keeping the Essence Make Me Brow Gel. I really enjoy both of these. They're kind of staples in my collection, so I'm going to use and enjoy them this month as well. And the last part is lip products. Last month, I played around a lot more with like purples and pinks. I thought it was really nice for springtime. This month, I think I'm gonna play around more with reds. So I have 2 lip pencils, 3 liquid lipsticks, and 1 bullet lipstick. I'm just gonna show you swatches on my hand. This lip pencil right here is in the shade Red Tape by NYX. This one is a lip pencil by NYX, also in the shade Summer Tease. This is Venezia by Stila. It's a liquid lipstick. This middle one is Lovesick by Kat Von D. This top one here is Viola by Stila. And this is a bullet lipstick from Charlotte Tilbury in the shade Bitch Perfect. And I think I'll be able to make all these products work. I'm going to Miami later this month, so I really want to have some nice reds and purples to play with while I'm traveling. Very excited about these shades this month. My SD card is filling up, so I'm going to wrap up my conclusion a little bit more quickly. Let me know if you like this style of video or if you'd like to see it done a different way. I'm always open for feedback. In the meantime, that's everything I have. Thank you so much for joining me, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye, guys!